everyone.
Good evening.
A very warm welcome to our fourth big sing. And a special welcome to those who are watching us on YouTube. As usual, we've got Maestro Matthew at the organ, and we hope we've selected a good variety of familiar hymns and something for everyone to enjoy. We hope you'll join us after the singing for the usual bells of Central tea. We look forward to good singing and great playing of the organ. Could we please ask for no unwanted music from our mobile phones? So can we please make sure they're all switched off or in silent? Well, this time is Alan's asked me to research tonight's music. So I hope I've got the right information for all 14 songs that we're going to sing. So, without further ado, we'll have our first item. And our first, we'll give you the hymn numbers from stage 4. But the athlete will get something on the screen as well. And you should also have your sheets, so plenty of choice there. We start tonight with Charles Wesley hymn from his Maudlin State of Poems of 1744. A rousing hymn to start a familiar tune written by John Darwell, who was born in 1751, and he was the curate and later vicar of St. Matthew's Parish Church in Walsall. He wrote many hymn tunes, but only this one for Psalm 148 is in common use today. We'll sing all the verses from the hymn book. Ladies only for boy at verse 2, and gents only for verse 3. Rejoice the Lord is King, stage 4, number 449.
Thank you.
This hymn was written in 1974 by Sue McClellan, Johnny McLaughlin, Rybrook, all of whom were born between 1946 and 1951. So now we're going to sing Colours of Day.
Thank you.
back to the Christian Haver now. The internet tells me that this Reginald Haver, him, Reginald was born in 1812, published his 566 hymnals. Today, we sing it to the tune Belmont, written by William Gardner, rather than by the original Isaac Woodbury tune. The hymn is by Cool Saloon's Shady Rill, and we will sing verses 1, 2, 5, and 6 from the CH4168.
Yeah.
I certainly enjoyed that, thank you very much, choir. We now come to a hymn written by John Greenleaf Whittier in 1872. Whittier was an American Quaker poet who began life as a farm boy and labourer, shoemaker, but in 1836 he became secretary to the American Anti-Slavery Society. We sing this hymn, which is Dear Lord and Father of Mankind, to the tune Repton, written by Hubert Parry, better known for composing the old song Jerusalem. We will sing verses 1, 2, 3, 5, and 6, with gents only for verse 2, and ladies for verse 5. Dear Lord and Father of Mankind, it's number 485 in CH4. Now sing in Christ alone.
Tell out my soul, and it's number 286 in C8.
page 4.
Thank you.
a lady composer for our next item. Carolina Maria Noel was born in 1817. She wrote about a dozen pieces between the ages of 17 and 20, and then wrote nothing for the next 20 years, before composing many more pieces, including the one we're going to sing now. Ralph Vaughan Williams wrote the tune King's Western for this hymn, but nowadays it's more regularly sung to the tune Camberwell, composed in 1960 by Michael Brearley. This is the tune we use tonight for At the Name of Jesus, and it's number 458 in SCH4. At the Name of Jesus.
Thank you.
One is for you all to enjoy singing the songs, but also we always have someone along for one of our charities. And tonight I'm going to invite Vaughan McCafferty to come up and tell you all a little bit about St Andrew's Hospice. It's very close to where I stay, but it's the other end of the town, but it's in Airdrie, and I'm from Airdrie myself. So I'd like to welcome Laura to come and tell you a little bit about the work of St Andrew's Hospice.
Thank you.
12 to 10, she was resident in Baltimore and was engaged in public school work. Most of her hymns were written for children's services. We're now going to sing C84 number 77, Will Your Answer Go?
You have made the feast. Thank you for your presence. Thank you especially to those who have visited from near and far and have joined us here at Bells Hill Central Parish Church for this evening of delightful hymn singing. The church is still the place where we are able to raise our voices and join together in congregational song. And so first and foremost, let's give ourselves a hand for the ways in which we have praised and delighted in God's presence. Fellowship and friendship. Our most obvious and immediate thanks must go to Alan, our old friend. All organists are profoundly humble, none of them appreciate Thanksgiving, and that's why we just want to give him another round of applause. If you are wanting to delight with us, and if you ever have a spare moment, friends in the community who want to belong to a specific congregation, we do recommend our life together here at Bells Hill Central Parish Church, and that was the choir, that is our weekly choir, and so we want to give thanks as well specifically for the anthem that they shared with us tonight, All That I Am. We want to thank Lorna McCafferty from St. Andrew's Hospice, who's come to share their mission and their ministry with us. We pray blessing, and also thank you, each and every one of you, for your generosity towards such a worthwhile cause. And then I'm going to mention a few names, and then at the end of that, we'll also give a moment of applause. These are people who have contributed both immediately and behind the scenes. Those lovely pamphlets that you received, Lawson and Jean Carl, were responsible for them. Hugh Ainsley, who has been our compere, our master of ceremonies for this evening. Jane Aitken, who has already made her way into the back, together with Leslie Marshall and their team. There's a whole team of them, quite frankly, who prepare tea and coffee. Drew Aitken, who's here in front, in charge of the screen, and who will ensure as well that this is published far and wide by our YouTube channel. If you do want to find us, we are on Facebook, and also we do have a website. And anyone else that Alan has forgotten, as all good organists remind us, you know who you are. And so that obviously includes all of us. Let's put our hands together once again in appreciation of a delightful evening. Close this evening before we join together in song with a prayer in thanksgiving to God who has made this evening possible. Let us pray. Then let us adore and give him his right, all glory and power, all wisdom and might, all honor and blessing with angels above, and thanks never ceasing and infinite love. Gracious God, the hymn writer Charles Wesley expresses it so well, and yet in each and every line that we have sung this evening, we have found a gift, a way in which the hymn writer, the poet, expresses something of our heart's desire and longing, to lose ourselves in loving adoration. Thank you for the gift of music, for the gift of choir, for the gift of song, for the gift in which we are able to share, for each of us, no matter how reluctantly, are pleased when we join our voices with others and are able to declare your praise in this time-honored way. Thank you, therefore, for our evening. Thank you for the way in which you have blessed our togetherness. Thank you that you will go out ahead of us into the night and help us, whether we go to places of rest or through this week to places of work and retirement, places of teaching and instruction, places of sharing and caring, places of friendship and family. Help us both in word and deed share something of your love and grace, your hope with the wider community and with the world. And so be with us in this moment and pronounce your blessing over us, even you, living God. You are Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. It has been our privilege to worship and adore you this evening. And we pray a special blessing upon St. Andrew's Hospice in their fundraising events, in their vital ministry and mission, in the ways in which they seek to offer presence, care, deliberate listening, and the ways in which they offer, most importantly, love. Thank you for the ways in which you have blessed them thus far and will continue to bless them. Thank you for blessing us as we have sought together in the strong name of Jesus Christ our Lord, in whose name we pray these prayers. Amen. Our closing hymn, which is pronounced as our benediction, the day you gave us, Lord, has it, the darkness falls at your weakness. To you our morning hymns are sent, your praise shall sanctify us.